Hello students, welcome to the class. Today we are going to discussing about alkenes, alkenes preparations and chemical properties. First one is decarboxylation. Whenever you have the decarboxylation, you have to consider the soda lime. Soda lime is a mixture of calcium oxide and sodium hydroxide. Soda lime is a mixture of calcium oxide and sodium hydroxide. Sodium salts have carboxylic acids on reaction with soda lime. Sodium salts have carboxylic acids on reaction with soda lime. On heating with soda lime, we will get alkenes. In this process, you will get a hydrocarbon which contains less number of carbons than the sodium salt of carboxylic acid. So the hydrocarbon contains one carbon less than the salt of carboxylic acid. The hydrocarbon contains one carbon less than the salt of carboxylic acid. Next, another preparation, fourth cellulosis. Fourth electrolysis. Sodium or potassium salts have carboxylic acid solutions. Sodium or potassium salts have carboxylic acid solutions on electrolysis. Sodium or potassium salts have carboxylic acid solutions on electrolysis yields the alkenes. So these two liberated cathode, these two liberated anode. Cox electrolysis means sodium or potassium salts of carboxylic acids on electrolysis. Sodium or potassium salts of carboxylic acid solutions on electrolysis will yield the alkenes. Next, cementitious hindrance reduction. Cementitious hindrance reduction. Alkenes on reduction depends on nickel catalysis. Alkenes on reduction in presence of nickel catalyst, we will get alkenes. Alkenes on reduction in presence of nickel catalyst, you will get the alkenes.
Give you the higher alkenes.
So alkyl halide This Wood-Jewell reaction will take place either with free radical mechanism or ionic mechanisms. We don't need these mechanisms here, just you have to know that in which process the free radical, this Wood-Jewell reaction will take place. It takes place either with the free radical mechanism or through the ionic mechanism. Kolb's electrolysis takes place with the ionic mechanism. Kolb's electrolysis takes place with the Kolb's electrolysis takes place with free radical mechanism. Okay? It is not ionic, it is free radical mechanism. In Kolb's electrolysis, you will get a small amount of esters also as a product. In Kolb's electrolysis, you will get a small amount of esters as the products. And another point in the properties of Kolb is alkanes. Properties of alkanes. Alkanes exhibit configurational isomerism. So alkanes exhibit configurational isomerism. This is possible due to the free rotation of carbon atoms basing on sigma bonds. Free rotation of carbon atoms is possible due to the free rotation of carbon atoms along basing on this sigma bonds. Next, we will look at the halogenation reactions. Methane on reaction with chlorine in presence of sunlight. Methane on reaction with chlorine in presence of sunlight. We get ethyl chloride. This process will take place until all the hydrogens are replaced with the halogens. This process will proceed until all the hydrogens are replaced with the halogen. This reaction will take place with the free radical mechanism. This reaction takes place with the free radical mechanism. Reaction of alkanes with the fluorine is vigorous, takes place in absence of energy source, means it takes place in dark also. Reaction with alkanes with bromine takes place at high temperatures, somewhat high temperatures. Reaction of methane with iodine is reversible process. Reaction of methane alkanes with iodine is a reversible process. Hence, this reaction is carried out in presence of strong oxidizing agents like nitric acid, iodic acid. These reactions are carried out in presence of strong oxidizing agents like nitric acid and iodic acids. Next, halogenation of alkanes. This is the halogenation. Next one is nitration. Methane on nitration, on reaction with nitric acid, will get nitromethane. Methane on reaction with nitric acid, you will get the nitromethane. Next, sulfonation. Methane on reaction with the sulfuric acid, you will get sulfonic acid. It undergoes sulfonation, it undergoes nitration. higher organs also undergoes isomerization. This is an higher organ when this one heated with anhydrous AlCl3, and this is heated in presence of anhydrous AlCl3. You will get an isomers. We'll get the isomers of this organ. Controlled oxidation, catalytic oxidation. Methane, an oxidation with copper catalyst at 300 degrees centigrade, we get methyl alcohol. Methane, an oxidation with atmospheric oxygen, influence of catalytic influence of copper catalyst at 300 degrees centigrade, we get the methyl alcohol. Methane, an oxidation, influence of molybdenum oxide, we get formaldehyde. We get the formaldehyde. Methane on oxidation with molybdenum oxide, we get the formaldehyde. Methane on oxidation with manganese acetate, we get acetic acid. Methane on oxidation with manganese acetate, we get the acetic acid. So these are the oxidation methods of methane. This is especially, two methyl butane. This two methyl butane on oxidation with the strong oxidizing agents. Two methyl butane on oxidation with strong oxidizing agents, we get alcohols. We get the alcohols. Next, pyrolysis. Pyrolysis. Pyrolysis means heating in absence of air. When this alkane hexane is heated in absence of air, you will get hexane. Actually, you will get different types of products. One of them is hexane. Get different products. So all these products will be obtained when hexane undergoes pyrolysis process. These are the reactions of alkanes. Now look at the MCQs in alkanes. The major product obtained when butane is treated with bromine in presence of lignins. So when butane is treated with the bromine in presence of light, we get a major product. They are asking what is the major product. When butane is treated with bromine in presence of sunlight, we get this one, 2-bromo. So here you have primary carbon, this is the secondary carbon. Secondary free radicals are somewhat more stable than primary free radicals. Hence you will get 2-bromo-butane. Next. Fully eclipsed conformation of L-butane is least stable due to the presence of fully eclipsed form. So this is the fully eclipsed form of butane. Now they are asking why it is unstable, because in this fully eclipsed form you can see the repulsive forces. Due to repulsive forces and the angle strain and steric interactions, this will become very unstable. So number one is steric strain, that means angle strain. And these two bond pairs are very close to each other. Next. In which of the following configuration of ethane, a new CC bond is formed? A new CC bond is formed in Kolb's electrolysis. Example. Sodium and potassium salts are carboxylic acid solutions or electrolysis. We will get this one. Okay, the alkanes are formed at anode, these two are formed at energy barrier between steered and eclipsed form of ethane. So it is the start question, energy barrier is staggered and emits a form of ethane is 2.9 kilocalories per mole. It is 2.9 kilocalories per mole. Methyl propane and oxidation with KMnO4 will give you 2 methyl propane. Methyl propanol is half-time. Next, aromatic list of enhancer. The catalyst used is aromatic list of enhancer. The catalyst used is which reagent is suitable for the oxidation of methane with molybdenum oxide, which is formaldehyde. When methane is made to react with halogens, halides are formed. The order of reactivity. Order of reactivity of halogens are chlorine greater than, fluorine greater than, bromine greater than, iodine. Next one is, how many products are possible by the monochlorination of propane? So this is propane. This is undergoing monochlorination with sunlight. Now they are asking how many products will be formed. This is one product. is the second product. Two products will be formed. Next, what is the byproduct during the chlorination of methane? What is the byproduct during the chlorination of methane? Look at here, very important. So methane chlorination is a free radical mechanism. Methane chlorination is a free radical mechanism. Here you will get methyl free radical and chlorine free radicals. Here you will get methyl free radicals and chlorine free radicals like this. I am showing the mechanism. Chlorine membranes have sunlight. Two free radicals are formed. And HCl will be alkaline. If two methyl free radicals comes into contact, then you will get ethane. If two methyl free radicals comes into contact, you will get ethane. Similarly, if a chlorine free radical comes into contact with methyl free radical, then we will get methyl chloride. Then you will get the methyl chloride. So what, this is the byproduct, this is the major product, this is the byproduct. So in methane chlorination, the byproduct is ethane. Next, wet ether is not used as a solvent in Wood's reaction because the water present in it hydrolyzes the alkyl halides to form alcohols. So, in Wood's reaction, dry ether is used. You used wet ether, then alkyl halides undergoes hydrolysis and they give you alcohols. Propane can be best prepared by the reaction of So this is the second year part. So alkanes are best prepared with lithium dialkane lithium cuprate. With these things, you will get pure alkanes. You will get the pure alkanes. Next, an alkane cannot be chlorinated by using the reagent HCl. Next, methanamides means the substances which releases methane on hydrolysis. Air4C3 and hydrolysis will yield you methane, which at 400 degrees centigrade are reaction with the nitric acid, which give you nitromethane. How many chiral compounds are possible on monochlorination of 2-methylbutane? So 2-methylbutane is there. This is 2-methylbutane. And this one is undergoing reaction with chlorine. They are asking how many isomers are